Sangsahar sindhu tarani hidayan jadi sad Sankirtanamritarase ramate manoshe Premam budho viharani jadi chitta viti Chaitanya chanda charane kurutanuragam Chaitanya chanda charane kurutanuragam Sangsahar sindhu tarani hidayam jadi sad Sankirtanamritarase ramate manoshe Premam budho viharani jadi chitta viti Chaitanya chanda charane kurutanuragam Chaitanya chanda charane kurutanuragam Gauriya Goshtipati Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, we are going to die shortly. We are not going to live here in this material world forever. We are going to leave our body. So before dying, we should think properly. We should have clear conception about this point, that after death, where we can go? We can go. We should have clear conception about this point. Where we can go after this body, after death, where we can go? What will be our situation? If we think over and again about this point, over this point, then we can, by the mercy of Guru Vishnu, we can settle down. What we want, what we don't want, there should be one final settlement of this point. What we want, what we don't want, sometimes want this, sometimes not. Actually, we have come here in this material world for the only reason, that is called Hari Bhajan. But at present, due to Maya, we feel there is so many responsibility we have. At present, we think we have so many responsibility for the society, for family, this, that, for my body, mind, so many responsibility. But to be frank, we have only one duty, one responsibility, one duty we have. That is called actually Hari Bhajan. That Hari Bhajan I was discussing, and again I can discuss in details. Almost my writing is complete. Almost one kind of thesis about Jeev Tattva. Big. What not? Everything there included. What you can think, what you cannot think about Jeev Tattva. Everything. So actually, I already discussed some point about this, that actually Sarup Shakti, the power of Sarup Shakti is almost nil inside Jeev, Jeevatma. That's why they cannot do bhajan. Automatically they cannot do bhajan. For that they need power. Bhakti can only be transferred by Guru Vaishnava, can be given. Automatically bounded soul cannot do bhakti. And one point, why we are ready to bhajan? Actually, Supreme Lord is always saturated. Supreme Lord is actually no demand, nothing, no dissatisfaction. Those bonded souls, they have dissatisfaction, dislike, dissatisfaction, everything. But actually, nijalabha purno. In Sanskrit, we say, Supreme Lord is nijalabha purno. And all those pure Guru Vaishnava, they are also nijalabha purno. Nijalabha purno means already satisfied. You cannot give something from outside to satisfy him, not possible. Naivat manu pahurayam nijalabha tushta. This sloka. Naivatmano pavurayam nijalabh purno manam jana davidusho karuno vinite Jajjajjano bhagavate vidathi tamanam tachatmane pratimukhasya jatha mukhotsi. Very important slogan. Naivatmano prabhurayam nijalabhapurno. Naivatmano prabhurayam nijalabhapurno. Manam janada vidusho koruno vinite. Jajjajjano bhagavate vidadhi tamanam. Tachatmane pratimukhasya jatha mukhasri. This sloka speaking. Very clear. Naivatmamo purayam nijalabhapurna. Prabhu, Supreme Lord, always satisfied Himself. That's why before Rasa Lila it is written, though Supreme Lord is satisfied, but still doing Krida. Still doing this kind of Krida. So common people can express doubt, it's not good, it's not, you know, proper. But it is written in Srimad Bhagavatam, though Supreme Lord is satisfied, totally satisfied, still is going to do this kind of Leela. For why? To give us kripa. To give us kripa, nothing else. So, naivatmano bhavurayam nijalabh puruno manam janada vidusho karuno vinite. Actually, to give, to show mercy on us, to bestow mercy on us, he is doing. Jajjat jano bhagavate vidadhita manam. Bhakta Bhagavat, Grantha Bhagavat, and Supreme Lord also Bhagavat. Supreme Lord is Bhagavat. Bhagavaji Mahapran, Bhagavat and Bhakta Bhagavat. For both of them, we can say this way, they are always satisfied, saturated. You cannot give anything from outside to give them satisfaction, because Bhakti itself is Amrita. In Bhagavatam, we can find Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking in front of those gopikas, when all Brajavasis meeting there in Kurukshetra, you know, midway. From Darika they come halfway, and from there they coming. So when they meet, they are speaking this way. Krishna, very secretly, speaking in front of Gopikas, that Mai Bhakti Dhibhutanam Amrita Thaya Kalpate. Mai Bhakti Dhibhutanam Amrita Thaya Kalpate. Any Jivatma doing bhakti unto my lotus feet, itself Amrita. You need not run here and there, Kumbh Mela here and there to collect Amrita. That Amrita is useless. That Amrita is useless, we don't need. As no long-term effect you cannot get out of that Amrita. But Amrita has some effect, but this Amrita, Bhagavad Katha, Bhakti is Amrita. This can give you eternal benefit. That's why in this sloka it is written, Prahladma speaking actually. So why we are going to serve Supreme Lord, we are going to serve Guru Vaishnava, but Maharaj, nothing. Actually, we are going to get benefit out of that. Follow. Why we are going to serve Supreme Lord, Guru Vaishnava? Because to get some benefit. Not that Supreme Lord going to get gain something. Nothing. So that's why it is written, though we are going to show bhakti, we are doing bhakti, but out of that we are going to get benefit. What benefit? Progress in our bhajan. We can go, approach. Gradually. This is the point. And the first sloka I started with, you see, if you want to cross away this material world, in that case you will have to do Sankirtan, Sankirtan Ras. you will have to go deep and deep into Sankirtan Ras. Sangsara Sindhu Uttarani Hidayam. If you like to cross over this material Sangsara, material world, Sankirtanam Ritarase Ramati Manuschet. Chet mean Yadi, Yadi. Provided, Yadi, if your mind, is going to get some enjoyment out of this Harikatha and Kirtan, then be sure that you are going to come out successful. In that case, you are advised to concentrate onto the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sankirtan Pita. And automatically, in the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, there is all Guru Varga. And the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, all Guru Varga there. They are roaming around the lotus flower of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, lotus feet. All Guru Varga. Sri Chaitanya Padambhuja Madhupebhyo Namo Namaha. I told many times, Sri Chaitanya Padambhuja Madhupebhyo Namo Namaha Kathanchid Asrayad Yesam Saampitad Gandhavab Bhavet. It is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami writing, Sri Chaitanya Padambhuja Madhupebhyo Namo Namaha. Sri Chaitanya Padambhuja Madhupebhyo Namo Namaha. Madhupebhyo Mano Bhamra, Brahmar, honeybees, roaming around the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, which is just like lotus flower, more than lotus flower. To get makaranda, makaranda means honey. They are collecting honey, doing sankirtan, collecting honey, all the time to get, and a feeling of intoxication and transcendental bliss, they are feeling all the time. This is the procedure. So, actually, we are going to do Sankirtan to satisfy Supreme Lord. Be careful. Sadhan Bhakti, one by one, I can gradually discuss about someday. Details discussion about Rai Ramananda Sangha. Sadhan Bhakti, why you are doing? Sadhan Bhakti, we are doing to get pure Bhakti. Ultimately, sadhan bhakti means through your sense organ you are trying. You are trying actually. Actually, through material sense organ, you have all material sense organ, material mind, sense organ, everything. But through material sense organ and mind, bhakti is impossible. You cannot do. But still we are trying. When you are trying this bhakti, practicing, this practicing, you see, through our sense organ, material sense organ, it is called sadhana bhakti. Sa sadhana vidha. Kiti saddha je bhavaha. This book I can discuss someday. So actually, after the, actually, pure bhakti, savan through harikatha kirtan. This harikatha kirtan, for us, bonded soul, it is one kind of bhajan mode. Ninefold bhakti, I already told you. Savanam kirtanam ittadi. Say, savan, our savan kirtan. Our savan kirtan is one kind of sadhan bhakti. It is one kind of bhajan mode. But this savan kirtan becomes sadhya in the life of those siddha mahatma. Follow. Those who are Siddha Mahatma, those who are pure devotees, for them, those who are Siddha Mahatma, for them, this Sadhan Bhakti is, this is not Sadhan Bhakti, it's Sadhya. After Sadhan, the goal which you are going to attain, that you can get through Harikatha Kirtan. Through Harikatha Kirtan, if you find Krishna is standing here, you can feel all Rasa Tattva, Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan, what we are discussing, if you can feel from heart directly, then be sure it is one kind of, not sadhana, it is sadhya. Through sadhana, we are going to get sadhya. But for pure devotees, those who are pure devotees, for them, it is automatically sadhya. It is one to go, one. And already I can discuss, I already discussed and still I can discuss Nitya Siddha Krishna Prem Saddha Gubu Noy Sobanadi Suddha Chitti Kare Udhoy. Nitya Siddha means eternally it is actually Siddha. It is waiting for us to come. Nitya Siddha Krishna Prem Saddha Gubu Noy. It is eternally there in Goloka waiting for us. That's why Krishna speaking in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Ami bina Krishna prem dita nahi shakti. All other avatara of Krishna cannot give this prema. Krishna speaking, prema is my only property. So, my sole property, prema. Ram, Nishinga, Baraho, they cannot give prema. That's why in Chaitanya Charitamrita reading, Ami bina Krishna prem dita nahi shakti. Except me, nobody can give this prema. It's my own property. If I distribute, they can get, the rest not. Nitya Siddha Krishna prem saddha gubu noy, sabanadi suddha chitti karayuda. Through saban kirtan, saban kirtan, sankirtan, pure. If your heart is pure by the association of Guru, Vaishnava and Sankirtan, then automatically this prema can appear inside your heart. So actually, this depends actually how we are doing association, pure association, how we are doing Sankirtan, this is all very important factor. Now actually, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Sankirtan Pita, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is saying through Sankirtan you can get a Saddha Sadhan Tattva Jekishi Shakal, Nama Sankirtana Paibe Shakal. Saddha Sadhan Tattva, Saddha Sadhan, etc., anything there, all you can get through Nama Sankirtan. All you can get, everything. Now today is the disappearance day of Srila Ramananda Ji, the eternal person of Chaitanya, not only eternal person, a very, very with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has a confidential relation, very secret relation, antaranga parshad. Eternal parshad, okay, but see intimacy, intimate person, intimacy there. Today is the disappearance day of Srila Rai Ramananda Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu's very, very main parshad actually. Rai Ramananda and Sarup Damodar. They are the two. These two actually, all the time when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu at the last time, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to leave this material world, before that, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was feeling this kind of Radha Prema, very secret, all the time. That is exclusive topic actually. All the time, day and night, Mahaprabhu deep into this ocean of Prema, cannot feel, if anybody there cannot see. That's why when all devotees from different parts of Bengal, they get together and going to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to meet their heart. Nitto nityanam shchetano shchetananam eko bahunam javede dhatu kamana se nitto nityanam shchetano shchetananam e Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He is the absolute chetan of all chetan. He is there. Where? In Purushottam Dham. So all Jivatma should feel total attraction, automatically. So all devotees, they are running to meet their heart, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, to see his lotus feet. But actually Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, ultimately, when at the last time, I already told how Chaitanya Mahaprabhu running here and there, after that how Chaitanya Mahaprabhu meeting with all devotees, this, that. And ultimately rest of the life, I mean rest of the time, all the time Chaitanya Mahaprabhu cannot say anything. All the deep into this ocean of love. Why did I, Ramananda Sarvadamadhar? Prabhu crying in front of all devotees, you are coming long way, taking trouble to come to meet me. I have nothing to give you. I don't know, I know not the reason. I don't know the reason for why at present I cannot go here and there. I cannot talk much. I don't know why. My mind is always inside. Excuse me for that. Always I am going inside. I don't know. Always, all the time, I feel some sort of, you know, pain all the time. That is called viraha, separation, a feeling of viraha. Mahaprabhu openly not speaking this thing. In front of all common devotees, Mahaprabhu not speaking this thing. That I am feeling a strong separation. Pranavallabh, Krishna. With Krishna, I am feeling a strong separation, Baba. This Mahaprabhu not openly speaking. Only in front of those devotees, Mahaprabhu speaking, I don't know the reason. I develop some disease. I don't like to run here and there. I don't like to go here and there, talk with you. I don't know why reason. What is the reason? I develop some disease. Really one kind of disease, prema roga. It's one kind of disease, of course. I don't know what is a disease. I don't like. Previously, I used to run here and there, dance with you. But at present, I like to stay in a very solitary place, only cry and cry. I like to shed my tears all the time. What happens, I don't know. This way, Mahaprabhu crying and speaking. So, first of all, we should know who is Rai Ramananda. Actually, Rupa Goswami Pad already told in Asambhav Sindhu, and Viswanath Chakravarti more clearly speaking, that actually Rakchandravartika, Itadi, etc. Grantha, there you can, Viswanath Chakravarti was compiled, there you can find, Viswanath Chakravarti was speaking, those who are Gaur Parshad, those who are Gaur Parshad, most of them, they have some sarup, they are in Krishna Lila also. Not always, because Gaur Lila is mixed. Gaur Lila actually mixed. And Nishinganada Brahmachari, he actually devotee of Nishingadev. Devotee of Nishingadev. But Gauranga Mapu is the Nishingadev, is there only. They came here mixed. Kobi actually now, Murari Gupta is the eternal servant of Ramchandra. He coming here. So Gaur Avatar is Gaur Avatar excellent. So different kind of devotees they are coming to take part. There is excellency here. Now actually point is there that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu doing this kind of Leela, you know why? Because this Brajopem was given by Krishna, little bit. But openly, this way was not possible. Without Krishna, nobody can give prema. Gulmo Lata, oh, actually this Kripa there. Kripa there in Vrindavan is not ordinary. So except Krishna, who is going to give prema to Gulmo Lata, to these trees and you know, to whom? But still, there is some restriction in Krishna Lila. Only in Gaur Lila we can find Gauranga Mahaprabhu with full kripa, giving distribution openly. That's why I discuss this point, patra patro vicharanam na kurute na saparam bhikshate diya deva vimarsaka nahi nava kalo pratiksha prabhu. Shaddo Savanakshana Pranam Pranamana Bhana Dina Durlabam Dati Bhaktirasam Sa Gauru Me Gatihi. So actually Patra Patra Vicharanam Na Kurute. Who is a proper Patra? Patra means pot. He is the proper part. According to that, Krishna Bhagavan can give prema. But Gauranga Mahaprabhu not that. Patra patra vichara na kurute. Even Muslim people, Muslim Kasai, with boat came. There was some big history, I cannot speak. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to cross from Pichalda, cross the river, then Muslim people were big beer to help Chaitanya Mahaprabhu cross the river. That time the Muslim fall down on ground with prema. Follow, how possible? Whereas this prema is Brahmaro Durlava Prem Sadakari Jachi. Brahma Sankar always crying day and night to get one drop of nectar, bhakti. Whereas Chaitanya Mahaprabhu disappearing, take away. That's why it is written. Who is pot, who is not proper pot? Oh, at all, if you don't have any pot, okay, you come, I can give pot and also I can give rasa, nectar, both. Patra, you have no pot? How you can drink? So I can give pot and give rasa also. This kind of kripa is only possible for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, not for anybody. So actually, it is written, directly we have no way to get kripa. Directly we have no way to get kripa. As was a special case, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming through bhakta, doing kripa, sometime as a, he expressing the mood of devotee. This way acting. Actually, Rai Ramananda Sarva Dhammadhar. It is some contradiction, somebody speaking that Rai Ramananda is a Vishakha Sakhi, somebody speaking Lalita Sakhi. But anyway, in my Rai Ramananda Sangbad, according to Guru Bhargo, I wrote that Rai Ramananda is Vishakha Sakhi and Sarva Dhammadhar is Lalita Sakhi. I wrote this way. Vishakha Sakhi is Rai Ramananda Mahasaya and Lalita Sakhi is Sarva Dhammadhar. This way. Actually, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was deep into the ocean of Prema, Radha Prema, always testing, getting the taste of Radha Prema. That time, exclusively Chaitanya Mahaprabhu staying inside Gambhira Mandir, a solitary cell, and that time, all the time, almost 24 hours, discussing Tattva, Vigyan, sometimes some Harikatha, Kirtan, all the time. Rai Ramananda Sarva Dhammadhar helping Mahaprabhu. Rai Ramananda Sarva Dhammadhar helping Mahaprabhu. Why helping? Actually, they're actually staying all the time with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to discuss Harikatha and Kirtan to check the Baba of Mahaprabhu. All the time, abnormal Baba. It's impossible. So, they are always staying with Mahaprabhu. Actually, we are going to discuss something about say Rai Ramananda Mahasaya. Who is Rai Ramananda? We say actually Vishakha Sakhi. Already I said. About Rai Ramananda, it is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita. When Mahaprabhu wanted to go to South India to distribute kripa among all people, common people. That time actually Chaitanya Mahaprabhu thinking how to go, where to go, this way. That time Sarvam Vattajajyo giving some indication. Indication means advice. Prabhu, I have one request. What? Actually, you are going to Dakshin, south. So it is my request. You must meet with Rai Ramananda, the governor of Vidyanagar. Sarva Vattajajyo, who was expressing the Lila of Mayavad. That Sarva Vattajajyo full of prema at present. That Sarva Vattajajyo speaking in front of Mahaprabhu, because Sarvabhauma Uddhar. Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya was delivered before going to South India. Before going to South India. So, Sarvam Vataja is requesting Mahaprabhu, Prabhu, I have one request. If you pay attention, it's very good. Because you are going to South India, it is my request, you must meet with Ramananda, the governor of Vidyanagar. Because previously, I was joking with him. Usually, I was joking with him. Because he was a devotee and I am actually Gyani, topmost. So now I know, by your mercy, by now I know the glory of Ramananda Mahasaya. This is my request. If you go to South India, you must meet Raya Mahasaya first. If you meet with Raya Mahasaya, then you can feel what kind of devotion he is having. What kind of excellency, what kind of rasa tattva is having. That time I couldn't realize. I was always joking with him. Now I realize, Prabhu, by your mercy. So it is my request, if you go to South India, first of all, it is my request to meet with Raya Mahasaya. You can understand. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu actually going to where? South India. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to South India. That time actually, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu reaching Godavari tat, bank of Godavari, there Mahaprabhu at the bank of Godavari under a banyan tree, sitting very nice with folded leg and doing Hare Krishna Mahamantra. That time suddenly it is the arrangement of Supreme Lord Himself. He find with full music and full trim, full troops actually coming. Who is that? Actually, Raya Mahasaya coming. But the governor of Bengal, governor of Orisha Vidyanagar, he is coming to take bath in Godavari with some rules and regulation. He has some Vedic hymn, chanting, some Mangalacharan, those Brahmins, they are shouting Vedic hymns, they are. And after that, with full music and everything, Raya Ramananda coming. When Raya Ramananda coming, Raya Ramananda suddenly could watch. There is one Mahaguru, oh, so nice, like Shan. He watch Mahaprabhu sitting at the bank of Godavari, a banyan tree, under the banyan tree. Suddenly he approached Mahaprabhu, and paid dandavat. At the same time, they don't know what is the reason. They have some previous relation. That's why whenever they paid dandavat, Mahaprabhu taking him from ground and embrace, they embrace each other, then automatically actually they are shedding tears. Shedding tears actually. So Mahaprabhu asking, who are you? Then Raya Ramananda say, what to speak? Actually, I am Shudra. Shudra Ati Manda. I am actually Shudra. My name is Raya Ramananda. Actually, I am Shudra, Vishwai, a material person. Speaking this way. So when speaking this way, actually, that time, Mahaprabhu and Raya Ramananda developing their previous relation and love, they don't know why they embrace each other. After that, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu discussing with him something. After that, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to discuss some point, wanted to know, because Mahaprabhu speaking, oh, you Raya Ramananda, already the great Sarvam Bhattacharya already give me indication. Prabhu, you are going that way. Please, why not you meet with Raya Mahasaya? He's a fool of love, prema. No, don't speak that way. Actually, I have come to learn something about Krishna Tattva, Radha Tattva, Prema Tattva. I have come here to learn so many things. This way actually, MahaPrabhu speaking this way. This way MahaPrabhu discussing with him. So actually, MahaPrabhu wanted to discuss something, but Ramananda is busy daytime. Why? He is the governor of Orisha, Vidyanagar. So they fix up one time, they fix up one place, secret place, at the house of one Brahmin. Then actually, daily night time, when daytime they are busy, and the night time Ramananda coming in civil dress, very secretly, and meeting MahaPrabhu, and discussing all about secret Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan right from Karmarpan, right from Karmarpan, everything all gradually. Gyanamishra Bhakti, Gyanamishra Bhakti, after then Gyanmukta Bhakti, Gyan is not there. This way actually gradually going up and up. After that, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to hear about secret Lila of Radha Govinda. What is the glories of Radharani? All. Then Ramananda finally come to this point that this ecstatic love affair, feeling of this Radha Govinda, secret relation. That is called actually Parakya Bhakti, and even in Parakya Bhakti, Radharani is atop this way gradually Mahaprabhu. But while Mahaprabhu coming back from South India, then Mahaprabhu wanted to take Rai Ramananda with him to come back to Purushottam Dham. Follow. Mahaprabhu wanted to take Rai Ramananda with him. You come with you and me can both can stay in Purushottam Dham, and we can discuss Harikatha Harikirtan all the time. So why not you come with me at present? Rai Ramananda saying, Prabhu, actually, to be frank, I am actually a material person. And if I am going to Purushottam Dham, with me so many people following me, because I have some position, I'm governor, so please you go, very shortly I am coming. I am going to take permission from the king. I am going to take permission from the king of Orissa that I can convey him, I can request him. It is the desire of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he like to keep me with him as a servant. So let me see what he is going to speak. Ki bolen, what he is going to speak, let me see. Then Mahaprabhu coming back, gradually Mahaprabhu coming back to Purushottam Dham. And Rai Mahasaya, Rai Ramananda actually gradually coming, very shortly. Rai Ramananda taking permission from King of Orisha, that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu like to keep me with him, what you permit. Then king become very happy. King become very happy and speaking, what you speak? But you are actually lucky. You are actually very lucky. So you can go and stay with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. You can go and stay with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and you can get your salary, no problem. He is going to leave service. But still king saying, okay, you can go and serve Chaitanya Charan. You can go and serve Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and I can give you full salary, no problem. Follow. Then very shortly, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gone, very shortly, Rai Ramananda coming. And first of all, when Rai Ramananda coming, first of all he is going to Gambira Mandir to meet with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and pay Lord prostrate Dandavat. Mahaprabhu speaking, you coming here? Yes, I'm coming here. I have taken permission from the king. He's very glad he give permission with full satisfaction. He is saying, you can go and serve the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and I am going to give you full salary, no problem. So I am coming. Rai, you already taken darshan, already gone to Jagannath Mandir? No, no, no. Why? You coming here first? Why you should go to Jagannath Mandir first? You should go to Jagannath Mandir first, then you should come here. Why you come here first? Rai must say, what to seek Mahaprabhu? Actually, in Upanishad it is written, in Upanishad it is, this body is actually chariot. In Upanishad it is written, this body is actually chariot. And within this chariot, actually Krishna, the super soul, Paramatma, sitting, you, Mahaprabhu sitting. So actually, I couldn't calculate properly. Because the coachman, actually, who is guiding the rath, who is sitting in this rath chariot, he guide me up to you first. So what to do? Mahaprabhu laughing. You should go to Jagannath Mandir first, take this. What to do? This is actually chariot who is guiding me. He guide me first to you. So I come to you. Then I can go to Jagannath. This is not good. You should have gone to Jagannath Mandir first. You come here first, it's not good. This way, from that day onward, Rai Ramando staying with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, almost staying, night time going and day time coming. Almost night time through 3 hours going away. Because otherwise, Govindo, the personal sevak of Mahaprabhu, became very angry. Govinda, so late at night, you are also always discussing this point. You cannot allow Prabhu to sleep properly. Huh? What problem you are making? Then Rai Ramananda Sarvananda, Govinda became very angry. Prabhu, today we are going. You take rest. After morning time, we can come. So what do you speak about rest? What do you mean by rest? When you are speaking Harikatha, doing Kirtan, that is my actually rest. When you can go away, when you go away, then you can find my condition. You cannot see what is the condition I feel. All the time I am crying, running here and there, restless. When you are speaking Harikatha, it is actually one kind of, actually perfect rest, resting for me. Otherwise, what you speak? This way, Rai Ramananda used to stay there in Purushottam Dham almost. Sometime Rai Mahasaya going to stay there in his village. Rai Mahasaya has a village home. From Purushottam Dham, I mean Nilachal, you know, Indodumna, Narendra Sarovar. From Narendra Sarovar, side by side one road going. Up to Alalnath. Halfway. I've been there. Almost 17-18 years back. I went there, the house of Rai Mahasaya. It is almost halfway. Alalnath is there. And, Narendra Sarovar. Where actually Chandman Yatra Mahotsav. Chandman Yatra actually every year, Jagannath for these 21 days. And Jagannath always traveling on a boat in Narendra Sarovar. Excellent Lila. That side actually, if you go, almost halfway, maybe 6-7 kilometer. Sometime Rai Mahasaya going to stay there in village home, and sometime staying in Purushottam Dham anyway. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu always discussing this Tattva with him all the time. Man, what kind of loving relation Mahaprabhu having with Rai Mahasaya? You will have to discuss this point. Rai Ramananda and Sarvudamada, two personal associates actually. So actually all day and night they are discussing. Krishna Tattva, Radha Tattva, sometime doing Kirtan, Sarvudamada doing Kirtan, Sarupair Kirtan, Kirtan by Sarup, and Harikatha or Siddhanta by Rai Mahasaya. All the time they are satisfying Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in support of his feeling. As and when Mahaprabhu, different time, different kind of feeling come. Sometime feeling that I am going to die without Krishna. Sometime laughing. Sometime Mahaprabhu watching this kind of Lila going on. Jalakrida, Jalakrida, no, water game. Sometime watching Mahaprabhu. Jalakrida. This way actually Rai Ramana Sarvadamodar giving support in favor of his feeling. But sometime when they are going outside of this Gambira temple, that time big problem happening. Sometime night time Mahaprabhu going out of this Gambira Mandir, whereas three consecutive gates, first gate, second gate, third gate all locking. And Mahaprabhu pass away. Sometime falling in ocean. Mahaprabhu thinks this ocean is actually Jamuna. Mahaprabhu thinking the Niljal, na, blue water. Na. Mahaprabhu thinking this is Jamuna. So Mahaprabhu sometime passing away from this Gambira Mandir. Three gates are locked. Big wall. Mahaprabhu going away, passing away. And going and falling down in water, ocean, and falling down. Nice Leela. Sarvadamadar, I am also, they all, whole life they are searching, where Prabhu gone. This way, gradually, they are traveling here and there to find out where our Prabhu is. Finally they found Prabhu in water, ocean water. This way, sometime they find Mahaprabhu there in Jagannath, outside of Jagannath Mandir, where Telanga guy, cows, all small cows, Orisha cows, they are eating prasadam. But the extra prasadam, those are panda, they are going to give this prasadam to Gomata. They are Gomata eating. They are Mahaprabhu lying down. This way, at different times, we can find Mahaprabhu here and there. But all the time, we can find Rai Mahashaya and Sarvadamodar giving support. All the time, actually. Sometime, they are speaking Harikatha up to 12 night over. 12 night over, they are discussing about Radha Tattva, Krishna. They are always Prem Tattva. And Govinda become very angry. That time they are bound to go away. That time. This way actually, sometime Mahaprabhu laughing, sometime crying. One day Mahaprabhu speaking, you are speaking. This Radha Tattva, a Radha, the feeling of Radharani, really we like to see. It's impossible, quite impossible. How it is possible? Then Raimasa says, you like to see? Yes, I like to see. Then Raimasa going away, taking one mirror and putting in front of Mahaprabhu, see. Mahaprabhu became very angry and throw the mirror. I am sannyasi, you are putting mirror in front of me. What to do? You like to see the Baba of Radharani. So what to do? No alternative. We put mirror in front of you. You see your own Baba. This way Mahaprabhu become very angry. But inside Mahaprabhu is very happy. Inside Mahaprabhu is always very happy because they are giving full supper all the time. And today we like to discuss some special point. Because Mahaprabhu giving indication. Ek Rai Ramananda hai oicho adhikar. Only and only Rai Ramananda in this full world. Only this Rai Ramananda having this kind of power, this kind of bhakti, exclusive. What kind of exclusive Baba? What kind of speciality? What kind of speciality? Then we like to discuss this point. Actually, Padunna Mishra, you know, Padunna Mishra, one of the associates of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, is staying in Purushottam Dham. All the time they are coming to take darshan of the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Someday, Padunna Mishra requesting Prabhu, I like to hear Harikatha from you. We like to hear Harikatha from you, actually. Could you please speak? Prabhu speaking, actually, Harikatha, I don't know. Harikatha, I don't actually. Whenever I like to hear, I hear from Raya Ramananda, but at present he is not there. He has some special seva there. That's why he is a village home. If you like to hear Harikatha, you will have to go. Why Mahaprabhu is speaking that, I don't know Harikatha? Why Mahaprabhu is speaking this way? Because Supreme Lord not going to glorify His own name. But when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu expressing Bhakta Lila, devotee, sometime glorify, but usually not possible. Krishna cannot speak about Himself, glorify, not possible. So actually devotees, they can glorify the name of, and already in Raya Ramananda Sangvada, you know, Raya Ramananda Prabhu, when Mahaprabhu is speaking, oh my God, now I know, that's why Sarvam Bhattacharya requesting me to meet you. By now I know your, oof, I never know this kind of tattva, Gopung, secret tattva, Radha tattva, Krishna tattva, Prema tattva. Now I learned so many things from you. Raya Ramananda laughing. I am saying, Prabhu, you are very clever. Actually, it is you who is sitting on my tongue. And you are, you know, according to your indication, I am dancing. My tongue is dancing. But now you are speaking that I am speaking Harikatha. You are speaking. And Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is speaking. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is speaking. Raya Mukhe Bhakta Swayam Gauru Raya. Raya Mukhe Bhakta Swayam Gauru Raya. At the mouth of Raya Ramananda, Gauranga Mahaprabhu himself speaking. Raya Ramananda himself. Raya Ramananda speaking that you are actually singing. You are making me an instrument. You are playing that instrument. And I am playing. You are playing this instrument, so I am playing this way. So, Raya Mukhe Bhakta Swayam Gauru Raya. So, all this kind of secret tattva, you are speaking in me and hearing. Both you are speaking and you are hearing. You are making me just an instrument, actually. That's why in Kirtan, you know, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Piyaya prem matto kori more suno nijo guno gaan. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Piyaya prem matto kori more suno nijo guno gaan. Like, is somebody giving some rasa? After that you are feeling some sort of intoxication. Follow? So, actually Sarvam Bhattacharya speaking, Piyaya prem matto kori more suno nijo guno gaan. Actually, you are allowing me to drink this kind of nectar. After that, when this nectar is up to this point, then automatically I am going to matto kori mane. When you are giving this kind of bhakti rasa, follow, prema rasa, then after drinking prema rasa, I feel some sort of intoxication. And when I am feeling intoxicated, you see those who are drinking wine, sometimes they are speaking all rubbish without any reason. They are speaking no causeless. So, actually, our Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Piyaya Prem Matva, you are actually giving this, you know, nectar. I am drinking. Piyaya Prem Mane, how? Because those sadhus, they are singing, I am drinking. Sometimes I am chanting kirtan through that. So you are actually allowing me to drink this kind of nectar. After that I am feeling some sort of intoxication. Then like mad I am speaking and you are hearing. This way, actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur was speaking, Piyaya prem matto kori more. Suno nijo gunagan. You are hearing about your own glories from me. It is you. You are doing everything. This way actually, Raya Ramananda, actually, all the time singing this kind of glories, but Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself sitting inside and singing. But now, actually, when this Padurna Musra requesting him, Mahaprabhu to speak Harikatha. Mahaprabhu speaking, actually, I am hearing Harikatha from Raya Ramananda. At present, excuse me, he is not here. If you like to hear Harikatha, you have to go to where? You can go to his village home. Then he took permission from Mahaprabhu. Now on that day actually, next day actually, Padurna Misra is going there. Where? Actually, his village home. Padurna Misra going there in village home there to hear Harikatha from Raya Mahashay. But when he reaching his home, he is asking, a servant asking, where from you are coming? Actually, my name is actually Raya Ramananda. My name is actually Raya Ramananda, actually. My name is Padurna Misra. So, I am coming to you to hear Harikatha. Because Mahaprabhu giving me instruction to come to you to hear Harikatha. That's why I am coming. First of all, when Raya Ramananda reaching there, that time he is asking, servant asking, who are you? Then speaking, our Prabhu, actually Raya Ramananda Mahasaya, he is busy inside. Inside room is busy, he cannot come at present. He is busy there, he cannot come at present. You can wait? Okay, I can wait. For a long time he is waiting there, but actually Raya Mahasaya not coming because servant not going to disturb him because doing some secret seva. After that, Padurna Misra asking, it's a long time I'm waiting. He is coming, he's supposed to come. No, actually he's busy. What kind of seva is doing? Actually inside room, actually there, secret place, there, Raya Mahashay serving some young girls, giving training to some young girls about he write one novel, Jagannath Ballabh Natak. Jagannath Ballabh Natak, there's some role to be played by young girls. They're serving Jagannath. That's why he is giving training, rehearsal. Rehearsal, you know? Rehearsal? Before one drama, we have to practice. This kind of practice going on inside this house, there is doing seva there, actually feeding those girl, young girl, changing their clothes, everything, and giving the indication how to dance, how to speak the Jagannath Bal. Oh my God, young girls there in secret place? Yes. Without speaking anything to the servant, he developed sometime hatred. So I thought he's a great devotee. He's playing with young girls. Oh my God, he come back. Without speaking, he come back. After night time over, daytime again coming to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, to meet with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu sitting in everybody, sitting inside the heart of everybody, ex-super soul. Mahaprabhu asking, you meet Raya Ramasa, hearing Harikatha? Actually I went there, couldn't get time to hear Harikatha. What happens? Ultimately I was bound to speak this way. I went there to hear Harikatha, but ultimately I was waiting for a long time. After that, actually, servant came in front of me as he is supposed to come. No, is what business he is doing this kind of thing. Mahaprabhu laughing. So you misunderstand, Raya Mahasaya. You are committing aparad. You will have to go to Raya Mahasaya again. You go there and hear Harikatha from Raya Mahasaya. He is only Raya Ramananda having this kind of power. Without reaction, his body is without any reaction. Follow. Mahaprabhu speaking, his body is without any reaction. Any circumstance, any situation is not feeling any kind of reaction. Only and only Rai Ramananda having this kind of quality. Don't misunderstand him. Don't try to misunderstand him. Be careful. Mahaprabhu giving warning. Mahaprabhu giving warning. Mahaprabhu speaking, you see, I am sannyasi. You see, I am sannyasi. I myself sannyasi. But I feel some reaction in the name of girl, woman. Oh my God. It's written there in Chaitanya, ami je sannyasi. Nijake birakto kori, I feel, I am sannyasi. I feel I have full detachment. But still, when I hear the name of girl and see, I feel some reaction. Mahaprabhu speaking this way, to give us lesson. Ami je sannyasi, nijake birakto kori mani. Sri naam, the name of Sri, woman. Sri naam jabahi shuni, tabahi bikar pai mor tonu mon. Sri darshan sthir rai oichu konjon. Who is there in this material world who is going to stay peacefully in front of woman? So Maya, Doibi Maya is more powerful. Put us in trouble all the time. So only Rai Ramananda having this kind of power. He is going to serve this young girl. You think he is going to serve young girl, but no. He is serving Radharani. He is serving Radharani. He is attributing. He is feeling. He never feels that I am a man and they are woman. Rai Ramananda have no. This kind of feeling is not there. This kind of feeling is not there inside Rai Ramananda that I am man and they are woman. Rai Mahasa serving those girls with full Seva mood. Rai Ramananda actually serving Radharani fully. Without any reaction. That's why changing their clothes, teaching them, giving rehearsal, some lesson to them, this way. So don't try to feel you are committing aparadha. Go! Then again, next day actually, this Padduna Mishra going again, where? To this village home of Rai Mahasaya. And there, that day, he was free. So servant giving information, then he is running and paying dandavat. Excuse me, I heard yesterday also you came, but mice is not speaking anything about your coming. So I couldn't know. I am committing a pard unto your lotus feet. You are waiting here for a long time and gone. Oh my God. So what seva I can do for you? Actually, Mahaprabhu sending me to you to hear Harikatha. What Harikatha you like to see? What Tattva? He is asking, Radha Tattva, Krishna Tattva, Bhakti Tattva, what? Anything. He started speaking. After that, Paddhunamushno came back to Mahaprabhu and speaking, Prabhu, you actually saved me. I was going to misunderstand Rai Mahasaya. I couldn't understand. This kind of power is there with Rai Ramananda. Yes, Rai Ramananda, only Rai Ramananda having this kind of power. Mahaprabhu giving us teaching, Mahaprabhu giving us this lesson, as and when you are feeling this kind of feeling, as and when you are elevated up to this point, then and all, only then you have your power to hear all about this secret prema tattva about Radharani Krishna. Ujjal Nilmani is that. When you are not feeling any reaction, it is written in Shastra. Prabhupada Bhakti, when you are feeling totally, you have no reaction inside heart. And that heart, you can get this kind of prema. Kama, with full kama, you cannot get prema. It's all absurd. With full kama, you cannot get prema. It's impossible. It's not possible. Kama is there, you can get prema, absurd. When kama, it is written there in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Jaha Krishna Taha Nahi Maya Rodhika. When Krishna is there inside your heart, Maya, how Maya can grasp your heart? How Maya can take control over your heart? If Krishna is there, Maya cannot stay. If Maya is there, the Krishna cannot stay. Follow, it's not possible. This way Mahaprabhu giving indication. Even Mahaprabhu time to time expressing different kind of Leela, you know? Mahaprabhu running towards Chatak Parvat, running like wind. Because Mahaprabhu hearing some sweet mellow song, sung by one lady. Git Govinda song. Some lady singing. Mahaprabhu like wind, running. So nice song. And Govinda shouting, Prabhu, Prabhu, don't run, don't stop. That's woman singing. Mahaprabhu stand like stone. Mahaprabhu cannot move his body. Just now is running like wind. When Govinda speaks, Prabhu, Prabhu, stop, stop, don't go. It's woman. Woman sing. Mahaprabhu stand and become like a stone. Mahaprabhu cannot move his body, like stand still. Govinda approaching, requesting, Prabhu, actually woman singing. Oh, Govinda, you saved me. You have done a lot for me. I was supposed to embrace. Who is singing? I don't know. I'm running there to embrace. Oh, you saved me. I'm sannyasi. If I touch that lady, what happens? Oh, Govindo, Govindo, tumi rakhila jibon. Mahaprabhu speaking in Bengali, in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Oh, Govindo, tumi rakhila jibon. You away. You are saving my life. If at all I am going to touch that lady, I am going to lose my sannyas. Now at present, sannyasis can do anything. No problem, nobody going to speak anything. You can do anything you like. But you can express, I am sannyasi. This sannyasi. Follow. So, stri parosaile hoito moron. I was about to die. Oh. This way Mahaprabhu explains this kind of lila. That Mahaprabhu, when speaking this way about Raya Mahasaya, Mahaprabhu speaking this heavily, that Raya Mahasaya is the only personality. Even I have no right to look woman. To look woman and king, I have no right because I am sannyasi. Woman and king, Vishayi, I have no right to see. But now, that Mahaprabhu speaking, that Rai Ramananda is the only personality having this kind of power. Even I don't have this kind of power. You see, that Mahaprabhu, many times, you know, about Chatauridas, giving so heavy punishment to Chatauridas. But for Raya Ramananda, Mahaprabhu speaking this way. Even you can remember inside Jagannath temple, one woman climbing the shoulder of Mahaprabhu. Village woman, very simple village woman, climbing this shoulder to see Jagannath. When Raya Mahasaya, everybody look, hey, get down! You are Mahaprabhu said, don't disturb her. Let her see Jagannath. I don't have that kind of, I also don't have that kind of, you know, strong desire to see Jagannath. If at all she is going to see Jagannath properly, let her see according, up to his full satisfaction. Up to her full satisfaction, let her see. Don't disturb. That Mahaprabhu speaking, that Raya Mahasaya is the only personality. Now you understand the glory of Raya Mahasaya, you see. So up to the last moment of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Raya Mahasaya was there with Gauranga Mahaprabhu all the time. You can remember when Sanatan Prabhu went, Rupa Goswami Pad first came, after that Sanatan came. Before, when Rupa Goswami Pad writing so many things in his book, Rupa Goswami Pad, And actually, with Raya Ramananda, Sarup Damodar, Mahaprabhu coming to check, to give darshan to Rupa Goswami. When coming to that bhajan kutir, he find that Rupa Goswami Pad was not there. Mahaprabhu check up, and from the rooftop he finds some writing, you see. Plum tree, skin, writing. Mahaprabhu gone mad. This kind of writing is great. So nice, handwriting, so nice. They are actually discussing among them. In the meantime, Rupa Goswami Pad. Rupa Goswami Pad, I think. Mahaprabhu asking, what you are writing? Eh? So nice. Rupa Goswami feeling sigh. With shrugging hand, head, standing. Mahaprabhu, this way, Ramananda speaking. Because actually, Vidagdha Madhav and Lalit Madhav, two. Vidagdha Madhav, Lalit Madhav, while Rupa Goswami Pad coming, Satyabhama came in dream. In one village, while he was coming from in a village, is Radhapur or Radhanagar, I forget. There Satyabhama came in dream and speaking to Rupa Goswami Pad, Rupa, you are compiling this nice novel, but you are compiling jointly. No, you make it separate. Dharaka Lila, total separate. Lalit Madhav, Vidagdha Madhav, totally separate. Vrindavan Lila, total separate. You make my Lila separately. Satyabhama came. Then Rupa Goswami Pad, get up. What happens? What came in dream? Then took decision to compile these two novels separately. Lalit Madhav said that. Then Mahaprabhu came there, then watching everything. So nice. Raima also having some discussion with Rupa Goswami Pad. Ramaswami passing remark, Prabhu, we have nothing to speak about Rupa. He is enjoying your full kippa all the time. Full kippa. That's why Rupa Goswami Pad writing this way. This kind of writing is impossible. Almost impossible, not possible actually. So up to the last moment of, you know, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu shortly disappear. After that, we know the condition of the Raya Ramananda, Sarup Damodar. They, one by one, they leave their body. Sarup Damodar leave body, Raya Mahasaya leave body, Gadadhar Pandit, all gradually they are going to leave body. Now, this is the situation. So, if Raya Mahasaya is not there, because in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Prabhupad, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, all our Guru Varga used to speak, and whole Chaitanya Charitamrita is very important. But most important factor is that Sanatana Sikha. First, Rupa Sikha. First, Sanatana Sikha, Rupa Sikha, and Raya Ramananda Sangbad. These three. First, Sambandha Gyan, Sambandha Vidyo, Prajan Gyan, all different discussion took place. Mahaprabhu going to give lesson fully. About the vast Tattva in front of Sanatana for 1 month, continuously 1 month. Rupa Goswami Pad, not 1 month, 10 days, I think, 7-10 days. So, this way, actually, Sanatana Sikha, Rupa Sikha, and actually, after Sanatana Sikha, then after the Rupa Sikha, after that, you will have to, if you are going to digest, Guru Padma used to speak, Guru Maharaj, Prabhupada, they all, if you can digest Sanatana Sikha and Rupa Sikha, then and only then you can understand the secrecy of that Raya Ramananda Sangbad. Raya Ramananda Sangbad is most important, very secret there, secrecy, right from the beginning, Jat Kurusi, Jat Asnasi, everything there, Tat Kurusha Madharpanam, from Gita you can say, Madhyaji Mang Namaskuru, Krishna speaking this. This way gradually Mahaprabhu going, actually Raya Mahasaya giving, and finally giving secret tattva about Radharani's secret prema, that is called exclusive thing. Radha Biraha Tatya. Topmost Tatya actually. Mahabhav Sarupini Radha Thakurani. This secret Tatya was spoken by Sri Raya Mahasaya. Today is the disappearance day of Srila Raya Mahasaya. So if we can discuss about Raya Mahasaya and we can feel, because at the time of this, when this top secret discussion was over, when Ramananda Sangvad was almost over, that time MahaPrabhu wanted to speak some question in front of Raya Mahasaya, one by one. In front of Raya Mahasaya, MahaPrabhu speaking. Who is topmost lucky? Dukher madde kon dukkho hai guru taro? Or separation, dukkho, grief. Where is the topmost grief? Then Ramananda one by one giving answer. As a feeling of separation from a Vaishnava, pure Vaishnava, is topmost painful. We cannot digest. It's biraha. Dukher madde kon dukkho hai guru taro in Bengali. It is the topmost dukkha, biraha, separation. Vaishnava, biraha, bina, biraha nahi ara. Those who are pure devotees, like Raya Ramananda, Sarudamada, when they are going away, this biraha should be the topmost biraha. If you can feel this way, then 100% you are going to go ahead. This biraha tattva all of all good, pure Guru Vaishnava can give you bumper success in your bhajan. This biraha tattva can give you bumper success. Material biraha, husband, wife, son, children, daughter. This biraha can throw you into the ocean of misery. This kind of separation, you are going to lose your son, you are going to lose money, position. This kind of separation can throw you into the ocean of misery, material ocean. But if you can feel separation for Guru Vaishnava, like Narottama Thakur, Pasane kutivo matha onole pashivo, Gauranga guner nidhi kotha gele pabo. Pem bhakti chandika prarthana pem bhakti chandika. Narottama Thakur going to throw his head with stone and blood coming out and crying. I can throw my head on stone. Pasane kutivo matha. I like to enter into fire. I don't like to live. Because I cannot bear the separation of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Pashane kutibo matha anole poshivo Gauranga guner nidhi kotha gele. Where I can get Gauranga? This kind of feeling of separation, if they appear inside your heart, Raya Ramananda gone, Sarup Damodar gone, all Gaur parshad, they gone from this material world externally. They are eternally, they are present. If this kind of separation is going to touch our heart, then be sure I can come out successful in our Raganuga Bhajan, 100%. Otherwise, no scope. I can memorize thousands of sloka, but still I cannot come out successful. As a secrecy actually, if you have any question, you can put any question. If you have any question, you can put in front of me, of not. What kind of question? No question. Tan manchakalpadurusikabasindhu bhavichavatitanang pamanupavishna bhyo namo.